Enable. Kotak Mutual Fund presents Invest Mentor in association with Network 18.
Hello and welcome to Invest Mentor, presented to you by Kotak Mahindra Mutual Fund in association with Network 18. It is an investor education initiative by Kotak Mahindra Mutual Fund, and I'm Sonia Shenoy. Now, on today's show, we cover Investment 101 for women. As many women are now becoming financially independent, we explore some ways women can ensure that they get returns from their investments regardless of their job role. In addition, how can they create a portfolio that offers long-term growth of wealth? To discuss all this and more, I have with me two industry stalwarts, Lakshmi Iyer, the President and Chief Investment Officer and Head Products at Kotak Mahindra Asset Management Company, and Rin Agarwal, the Founder of FinSafe India Private Limited. Ladies, thank you for joining me on Invest Mentor. Lakshmi, I want to start with you because, you know, traditionally, all the big financial decisions in a household were taken by men, right? Whether it's investing, whether it is sort of buying physical assets. But now things are slowly changing as both men and women have become equal breadwinners of the family. How do you, or how does one ensure that women get an equal chance in building their portfolio and creating a good corpus for themselves?
Hi, Sonia. This question, I think, is one of the most pertinent questions which is plaguing a lot of women's minds, given the fact that, as you rightly observed, they are also contributing towards the income stream as far as a family is concerned. I think the biggest stumbling block that women tend to encounter is that, is this arena really for me? And for all those women out there, I tell them, you know, just go on to Google and check out the top chefs. And what you actually see is there are a fleet of men whose names are featured. And somewhere in the corner, you find a lady's name being mentioned. And likewise, if you Google the top sports person, you actually have an array of women who are, you know, quite prominent out there. Why I'm sharing this is to say that it's important to conquer the mindset that investment is only a male arena. So once you have conquered that, the next level is to take active participation in the household, whether it's your spouse, whether it's your brother, whether it's your father, whoever it is, you know, you have to take active participation and say that this has to be done jointly. It can be done independently, but it's very, very imperative to get that thought right.
Mrin, I want you to come in on this because, you know, traditionally, women have been investing a lot in physical assets, whether it's gold or even just putting their money in a savings deposit. Now, how does one make the transition from physical to financial assets? What do you think the procedure should be?
Well, first and foremost, I think it's important to let go of some of our investment biases. Because obviously we are comfortable with investing in what we've seen people around us investing in for the longest period of time. The whole point is to really realize that it is important to take some amount of risk in investing. So, you know, for example, now because of the way the markets are, I run a women's community on WhatsApp and I have a lot of women asking me, okay, which stock do I buy? And I keep telling them that it's not just getting into a product, it's about assessing and getting into the product which can have the right amount of risk which will meet your profile.
You know, Lakshmi, I want to talk about those women who perhaps are not the decision makers just yet and want to be. So women who have a salary, who want to start investing and build a corpus for themselves. How do they start? What is the step one, step two, step three procedure for them?
So point number one is being aware that there are financial options which allow you to create a holistic financial plan for yourself. How do you really make yourself aware? There are, you know, reams and reams of information which is available all across social media, on blogs, on websites, on financial platforms, media such as yours. So everywhere, that's the place where you actually assimilate that information. And having done that, you either can do two things. So I think awareness is non-negotiable, and there you cannot use borrowed knowledge. It has to be self-knowledge. Having ascertained that, you have two options. There are DIY investors, but to this set of investors, I don't really recommend a DIY or do it yourself, because they are just being initiated into the world of finance. So therefore, the logical step therefore would be for them to engage with financial advisors, financial planners, goal planners, and try to actually discuss their financial situation, like the way we do it with a GP or a general practitioner about our physical health or what's ailing us physically. It's very important to go and share that and then curate a plan which is very suited to yourself. So it's not complex, but it's not simple as well. So it requires a step-by-step process. Initiating yourself into the world of finance, to my mind, has to be done as of yesterday, so you're already late.
Okay, got that. So there are two types of women, right? In general, I mean, one who is perhaps a traditional homemaker who gets a certain allocation of money to spend in the month, and the other one who is salaried. I mean, both have equal amount of challenges, but both have a certain amount of money that they put away in the month. So Mrin, working for both these classes of women, the traditional homemaker and the salaried woman, how does one invest? I mean, should both invest in SIPs? Is that the safest route?
Well, I think the first thing that they need to do is that, as Lakshmi also said, that you need to be aware and you also need to be aware of your family finances, right? And involved in that. Now, the second thing is to really then figure out what are the financial goals of the family. And based on the financial goals of the family, they have to start looking at various instruments that are there, both in short and in the long term as well. I certainly think that SIP has a place in everybody's financial life. I think it's one of those instruments that you can't do without now, right? And certainly, you know, they would need to, of course, read up on the various types of equity options that are there and look at start investing. And, you know, the advantage of the SIP is also that it allows you to invest with small amounts. So you could always put a small amount, try it out, check out how the experience is. But the whole point is you will need to do it in a structured way. And if you can get the help of a financial planner, great. But if you can't, then read up, figure out the right funds to put money in and start it with a SIP.
Oh, absolutely. A systematic investment plan, right? That's the best way to look at it, because not only can you start with small amounts, as you said, it also helps you balance the vagaries of the stock market. So every time the market goes down, you sort of buy at lower levels, and it helps you build a better corpus for tomorrow. Lakshmi, how important is it for a woman to create an emergency fund, and how does one sort of establish that fund?
So Sonia, in rains, how often do you end up not going out with an umbrella? I mean, you can go with a weather forecast, you can say it's sunny and I'm not going to carry my umbrella, and then invariably get drenched. Why I give this analogy is to say that emergency fund, to my mind, is a non-negotiable, and it's gender agnostic. We'll be talking about women here, so it's even more important. And the last, I would say, 15 to 18 months of this pandemic has taught us it has a drain emotionally, it has a drain physically, mental health also goes for a toss. And any which ways, women typically tend to have a higher life expectancy in general than men. So therefore, it's extremely important to plan for those days which are not in your control. And therefore, an emergency fund where you know that this is my go-to kitty whenever I require something, and it's an exigency, something which you may not have envisaged. And therefore, in part of every financial plan, I urge each one of you to surely go for that. The way to operate that, obviously, the modus operandi, it will go into lesser, riskier avenues, etc. That, of course, is a subsequent planning. But the need for having an emergency fund, to my mind, is an absolute given. And I don't think there should be any debate on that front.
Also, given that a large chunk of the women in India are homemakers, right? So they are not the breadwinners of the family. So they need to sort of create an emergency fund or a corpus for themselves. God forbid if the breadwinner either loses his life or gets into a life-threatening accident. So I guess more than the breadwinner himself, it is important for the woman to create a corpus. So I want to discuss that as well. But I'm going to take a short commercial break. Very interesting discussion lined up with our guests on how to invest 101 if you're a woman. More on that coming up on Investmentor. Stay tuned.
Kotak Mutual Fund presents Investmentor, in association with Network 18. Kotak Mutual Fund presents Investmentor, in association with Network 18.
Welcome back, folks. You're still watching Invest Mentor, presented to you by Kotak Mahindra Mutual Fund in association with Network 18. This is an investor education initiative by Kotak Mahindra Mutual Fund. And today I've been joined by two industry experts, Lakshmi Iyer from Kotak Mahindra Asset Management Company and Rin Agarwal, the founder of FinSafe India Private Limited. And we're discussing investments for women. Now, Rin, you know, traditionally, a lot of women have shied away from investing in risky assets like equities. Although I don't know why equities are termed risky, considering that A, you beat inflation, B, you have professional money managers to do it for, you don't even have to do the thinking, right? So debunk these myths for us.
So with inflation on most of the financial goals that you're saving for being very high, if you take into account education or, you know, marriage expenses, or you take into account other expenses, the inflation is really high. And with, if you really want to beat inflation and you want your money to grow, the only way you can do it is by taking some amount of risk. And as I mentioned earlier, take the right risk. So certainly, I think equities is the way to go. And to my mind, if you're really not that adept at money management, or, you know, you feel that you still need to learn a lot more about it, I think mutual funds provide you a good investment mechanism, because you have professional fund managers to take care of investments. You have index funds that are available, which are, you know, very simple. There's really nothing difficult about index funds in that sense. So you have a variety of options. On top of that, you also have various tax advantages. So the returns are tax efficient as well.
Lakshmi, coming to you now, I'm sure there are many women who are watching this show. So how does one structure one's portfolio, right? Because there's so much. There are index funds, as Mrin was talking about. There are balanced funds. There are large cap specific funds, mid cap specific funds, sector specific funds that you, if you look at. So if you had to sort of, you know, help us sort of structure our portfolio, what would it look like?
So Sonia, yesterday, one of my friends had messaged me saying that, you know, I want to go to a nice Greek restaurant, have some Lebanese food. And then she knows that I'm a foodie. And could I have recommended probably a Shiv Sagar to her? Answer is no, because I know Shiv Sagar is more about Udupi food. So I gave her a couple of options, which will, you know, probably specialize in Lebanese food. Why I gave this analogy is to say that depending on what your A, investment horizon is. Second, what is your risk appetite? As Min also beautifully put it out, one needs to plan investments accordingly. For example, and I started off with, you know, we discussed about the emergency fund, for example, that sort of money, however much time you have, because that's a kitty which is meant to be there for some time, that fund or that kitty cannot really go into volatile or risky asset classes, despite the longevity. Likewise, so what's important is to have that plan. And when you have that plan, you actually have to break it up into short, medium, and long term, saying that, okay, this is the corpus that I require for the next 3 months, 6 months, 1 year. And bulk of that money is actually get plowed into fixed income as an asset class. Likewise, the medium and long term money can go into combination of diversified equity, index funds, active funds, and of course, hybrid funds, which actually blend a combination of equities and fixed income. So clearly, there is no one size fits all, which is why I said for the initiated, a combination of do it yourself and some advice from an advisor or a distributor could help. But for most others, it's very imperative that you share your plan. And the more you share your plan with your advisor and get to know the pros and cons, the planning and the execution will be as seamless.
So Mrin, you know, just tell us, what should a woman do now in order to create a well-diversified portfolio? How do you create short and long-term goals for yourself? And how do you actually assess what your risk appetite is?
So there are two ways to assess risk appetite. The first, you can use a risk assessment tool. But I think the easier way is for you to figure out what risk you're comfortable with. So if you have 100 rupees to invest, out of that, how much are you going to put into a risky asset, right? So it could be 30 rupees, it could be 40 rupees. It's very easy. That's how you have to think about it, that out of 100 rupees, how much am I going to put into a risky asset? And that becomes your risk appetite, basically. Now, once you have the risk appetite in place, you start looking at your financial goals. Certainly for shorter term financial goals, which are, let's say, up to 3 or 4 years, you will need to look at debt funds. And within the debt fund category, there are different types of funds which cater to different investment horizons. So again, you'll have to look at a different fund if your investment horizon is 1 year, and you'll have to look at maybe like a short duration debt fund if your investment horizon is 3 to 4 years. Mm. Now, as your investment horizon keeps increasing, so let's say now you're looking at 5 to 7 years, you may consider hybrid funds like the Balanced Advantage funds or like the aggressive hybrid funds, which invest in stocks and in bonds. And as your investment horizon goes higher, which is 7 to 10 years and above, you have a whole variety of equity funds that you can look at. That's not to say that you cannot invest in debt funds for 7 or 8 years. You know, again, if your goal is, let's say, 7 years, and you decide that I'll put 30% in equity, you can put the balance in debt, right? So again, it's very individual. It's very personal to a person's financial goals, the time to the goal, and the risk that they're really willing to take. But this is pretty much how you basically allocate among different asset classes.
Well, that's very helpful, Mrin. I mean, you know, for people who are watching us, perhaps they would know how to at least start. But let's be honest, right? Women like us are what? 1%, 0.001% of the population who get to actually take the decisions in the family. A large chunk of the women are always second guessing themselves because most of the decisions are either taken by the husband, the father, or the son. At a time like this, Lakshmi, you know, what does one do? Does one stick to safer assets? And if yes, should one stick to, say, an index fund? Because for somebody who's perhaps not used to investing in a big way, this is a big step to take, right? I mean, investing the family money into assets. So how do you ensure that there are safer assets that you invest into within the equity bracket?
See, there's always a first time. So you have to take that plunge at some point in time when you start realizing that there is this a monster or a villain in real life called inflation, which is gradually and steadily eating into your savings. And that's really acting as a deterrent. You have to act. So it's as simple as that. You know, if you don't know how to swim, just plunge into the pool and start back, you know, floating around. And that's how you need to learn. So therefore, I don't think there is anything like a safe investment or a risky investment within equities. Equities offer market-linked returns. They are vulnerable to day-on-day movements, ups and downs. Whether it's an index fund, whether it's a diversified equity fund, it's all available. I think what's very key for investors, especially women, to focus on is that have a complementing strategy. It is okay to have diversified funds, because in India, to have a core strategy around diversified equity funds, but don't forget the index hugger funds, which allow you to probably mimic the index when the times are not so good. So I think blending the two together and having an optimal portfolio would be the solution, rather than trying to worry about what could be the contours of risk. Mm-hmm. So before you make your move, you're already worried and you're taking two steps behind.
Okay, got that. What are the red flags? Mrin, anything that women need to be aware about as red flags as one gets into equity investing?
Well, the first one is, of course, to get the investment horizon right. And, you know, there's this whole thing about chasing trends. So normally, you know, as Lakshmi was saying, that you need to have a good blend of both active and passive funds. Like over the last 1 year, all the questions that I get are around passive funds. And I keep telling people that you need to have a good blend of both active and passive. So I think, you know, just following one strategy, chasing a particular trend, these are some of the real red flags on equity investing. So it's very important to be well diversified. Don't be concentrated. From the non-equity space, I would like to say that there are a lot of new offerings these days. You know, clearly you need to understand the risk associated, let's say, with an NCD or a covered bond before you actually invest in those products over debt fund. So it's, I think it's really about understanding the risks associated and not following trends.
Okay, and I'm so glad we did this episode, because, you know, I'm passionate about investor education, but I'm a little more passionate about educating women to become financially independent. I think that is where the entire benefit for the family lies, right? Because she takes all the big decisions. All right, thank you so much for joining us, and it was really a pleasure speaking with both of you, Lakshmi and Rin. Have a great day. Well, with that, we come to the end of another edition of InvestMentor. Thanks so much for watching.
Kotak Mutual Fund presents InvestMentor in association with Network 18.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.
Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.